Today we will have a session from Open Thinking, who are giving us this as a gift for all our members in GCC and in mid-countries for Nissan.
Okay, so my name is Iyad Murtada. I'm the Managing Director of Open Thinking. And Open Thinking, we are in Dubai Knowledge Village. It's one of the most advanced business training companies in the UAE. So what we do, we focus on introducing ideas in completely different and new way. And one of the amazing workshops that we have, we call it, you know, the Leadership Challenge. And what is the difference about, you know, between this workshop and between any other workshop related to leadership that you attended? It's not about the ideas, it's about the practices, it's about the behaviors. It's about, you know, what you need to do for you to be a leader, not what, how you need to think, what you need to do, what are you actually doing, what are you actually practicing, and how can you do it better? So the main concept here, we believe that leadership is all about doing and practicing, and you need to practice it every day to be a better leader every day, rather than, you know, to need to think about it and do it, and now you are a leader and there's no progress there. So leadership is an ongoing thing. So before I start with, you know, our discussion and, you know, show you exactly what is the model, let me go and show you this video, this amazing video.
Here's to the crazy ones, the misfits, the rebels, the troublemakers, the round pegs in the square holes, the ones who see things differently. They're not fond of rules, and they have no respect for the status quo. You can quote them, disagree with them, glorify or vilify them. About the only thing you can't do is ignore them. Because they change things. They push the human race forward. While some may see them as the crazy ones, we see genius. Because the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do.
Change the world is the question.
Do you think I can change myself?
Okay, that's a good start. So in that way I can change myself. Do you know, changing yourself is much more difficult than changing the world, because changing the world I can so easily say, okay, something needs change, and it's easy for me, I can say that. But for me to go deep inside myself and try to change myself, it's really difficult thing.
But that is easier than changing the world.
For some people, like if you,
for example, changing the world for me is changing you.
Okay.
That's it. Or changing Tamil. That would be much more difficult for me to do that to kind of, you know, change my actions and behavior, mm-hmm, to influence you to change. This is what I need to say.
Yeah, definitely. When you need to think about change, you need to think like you said, about two things, about changing yourself and changing the world. And you need to understand, you know, how difficult for you to change yourself and how difficult for you to change the world. And how can you do it? You know, people, when you want them to follow you, first, you need to be the leader, and then you need to go around and telling them, you know, this is my vision, this is where I want to go, and would you follow me? So that way you need to change them for them to follow you. So when we go and we look at, you know, leadership, one of the things that's really important for us to understand is this: there is no big highway to the future. We don't know what is the future. One leader will take us in this direction, one leader will take us in this direction. We don't know which model next year is going to be the bestseller, because we there are no certainty. What we need to understand, that leadership will help us in understanding how can we get there. So it's a journey, we are taking a journey, and we want to be able to take it step by step, have all our people following us, for us to be able to achieve our destination. So what you need this, you know, lighthouse. You need this lighthouse to guide you into the true way. And once you are practicing the principles and the practices and the behaviors of leadership, what you'll be able to do, you'll be able to get to your destination and allow people to follow you. So let's go, you know, to the basics. Let's go to the concept of, you know, managers and leaders. What is the difference between a manager and a leader? Very basic things. What's the difference? Corina, she's going to be helping us here writing some of your comments. So let's start with the manager. What do they do, managers?
They manage the given
task. They manage
tasks,
okay.
Manage
resources.
Manage people,
okay. What also other things they do?
Also lead the group of people.
Okay, they need a group of people to help them in doing this?
Lead the group.
They lead the group of people, okay? But this is more to become, you know, they more they manage them. Lead them to get more to the leader. We'll discuss this. Okay, what other things managers they do? As a manager, what do you do?
Make the boss happy.
Make the boss happy. Okay. Don't you do review, control, planning? Organize.
Forecast, planning. Organize, yes.
Communicate, yes.
Manage to reach the goal.
Manage to reach the goal, yes. You do so many things. Some of them are boring, some of them are interesting, right? So
Delegate,
yeah. You need to do it as a manager. So these are all the things that you do for you to be able to get the job done. See, this is what managers they are doing. They are doing everything they need to do to make the job done, to organize things, to make things happen. Okay, now what about leaders? What do they do, leaders?
Set examples,
okay.
Leader, get the people follow, not like the manager. Manager control the people. Okay, to push them to follow. Mm-hmm. Leader with his charisma, people themselves follow.
Okay. Exactly. So in that way, they inspire people, right?
Exactly.
They inspire. What other things that leaders will do?
They set themselves as a role model.
Okay, so role model. Perfect. Other thing, leaders. Imagine you important leaders in your life, in your countries.
Influencing people, coaching people.
They coach people, yes. Think about
motivating people.
You know, think about, you know, leaders in your countries, leaders in your society, leaders in your organization. The leader of Nissan, right? What is he doing?
Hope.
Right? He's creating hope. He's creating a vision. He's inspiring people. So when we look at these, you know, actions that they do, see, this is the actions that they do. We can see something similar to this. Look what they see. This is managers. They control, they blame, they avoid conflict, they maintain, they reactivate, they bring right, avoid risk, delegate, focus on the results, plans, all this stuff that, you know, it's really, really, really hectic. But when we look at leaders, you know, they think about the vision, they develop, they break the rules, they motivate, they influence, inspire, facilitate, disturb, challenge. See, these are the things that leaders will do. And we need to understand that, you know, any leader should be a good manager. But managers, maybe they are not good leaders. Because what, they are doing all these activities, but they are not actually taking us somewhere. They are just making us stay still. If we need to look at it from different perspective, this is how I see it. See, this is manager, so this is the guy. He's just managing them, making sure we achieve the goals. But look at this leader. He's inspiring everyone and making them achieve this big vision, a big idea. So do you want to be this guy who's just managing? Or do you want to be the guy who's inspiring everyone and leading us somewhere? This is, in a way, what we need to understand. Now, it's really essential when you think about leadership to think, you know, you can't do it alone. It's not like something like, okay, I'm the leader. If I'm the leader and I have everything and I have the vision, people will follow me. No. You need to understand that you can be leader only if you have followers. And why is that? Look how nice is this picture. See, you are the leader because you trust them and they trust you. So you are on top. You are the leader. Otherwise, if just one of them will not follow, the whole thing will collapse. So you need to create this trust. You need to create and build this relationship for people to be able to be inspired by you and follow you and support you. Because at the end, without them, you can't achieve an objective. And when we think about, you know, leadership, it's not just you are on the top and you are leading the people, you know, who are reporting to you or that you are managing or that you are supervising. Leadership is an ongoing relationship. So look how we look at it. You are here, for example, in the organization. I don't like to see the hierarchy from the top to the down. You are here, you are working with other coworkers. This is leadership. You are working with your boss, you are managing your boss. This is leadership. You are managing your employees. This is leadership. Leadership is all over the organization, on each level. And when you implement it in this way, you are actually understanding how to deal with your boss, right? How to make your boss happy. This is, you need leadership skills for this. You need to inspire your boss to follow you. You need to inspire your other colleagues to follow you, and you need to inspire your employees to follow you. So we are speaking about, you know, different levels. Even in your life, you need to inspire your family to follow you, right? You need to inspire your friends when you go to a group to follow you. You need to inspire the community to follow you if you are visionary. So you need to understand how can you really do it actually in life. And do you believe in this? Do you believe that leaders are born?
In this part of the world, yes.
Yes. But maybe these are not the leaders. These are the, you know, the managers or the people who are in positions, who got authority. But you need to understand that leaders, what's the meaning of leaders? People that they will inspire you and you follow them. They are not born. They are created. And they are created based on what? Based on what they actually will do. It's not based on what they say. They can say forever after that if they are not doing what they are saying, you will not follow them. So you see the leader and you see what they do, and based on it you say, this is the guy that he is inspiring me, or I would like to follow on that, I would like to take him as an example. So you need to understand how can you really gain these skills for you to be able to become the leader that you want to be. See, there is no one leader. It's not Steve Jobs, it's not Gandhi, it's not Martin Luther King, not Sheikh Mohammed, it's the leader that you want to be. Because each one of you is going to be a different leader. And each one of you is going to be a great leader in his own way. This is really important to understand. So what are the basic concepts before getting into the world? So this is what we focus on. Leadership is everyone's business. It's not like you say, okay, well, I'm not a leader. Because I, for example, like I just conduct some training, so I'm not a leader. Or I'm just, you know, conducting some sales, so I'm not a leader. So you need to make sure that the employees in your company, they understand that the guy who's cleaning the floor, he's a leader. Why? Because he is working with everyone and he's inspiring the company. He wants the company to be the most clean, the most amazing environment by cleaning everything and making sure everything is perfect. Because in any situation, think about it. You are one of two things. You are following or leading, right? How many times in the day you are leading? Many times. Think about your family, your friends, your club, activities, whatever you do. Sometimes you are leading, sometimes you are following. So how can you do it? It's not about quality or characteristics. Or charisma. It's more about what? It's the behavior, the actions that you do. Because if you do these actions, and I'm going to show you what kind of behaviors that you need to do. If you do them, you become the leader that you want to be in the circuit that you are in, and you'll be able to influence people. The example that I was giving, you know, the guy who's coming at cleaning, this guy, maybe after 30 years, he's the CEO of the company. So this guy who's cleaning, maybe after 30 years, he's the CEO of the company. Why? He's walking around, he's looking at the process, he's understanding the process, and after that, he's trying to understand, you know, okay, I have a vision, I think we can change things. And now he needs to go around, inspire enough people for them to put him in the entry level position. And after that he will move up, and after that he will be what, the CEO. So think, you know, the guy who was working in the chemical factory in GE. After that he moved, he become the CEO. What's his name? Jack Walsh, right? He was just working there, he was, you know, working as a manager, and after that he moved up all the way and he become the CEO. Why? Because he got the vision and he was understanding how it should be. And he inspired people, and people, they were following him, and after that he became the leader.